Welcome back to my channel, everyone. I'm James Alcatraz, and today I'll be sharing with you one piece of advice that will catapult your photography to that next level. Listen, my goal for whatever hobby that I do is to constantly be growing and to reduce stagnation or creative block as much as possible. And in my humble opinion, the fastest and best way to do that is to create quality work consistently that makes you super happy. Now hold on, before you start to overwhelm yourself and overthink it, being consistent shouldn't raise your stress levels. Now I know when I think of consistency, right away I think that I have to dedicate an X amount of time, I have to do something, I'm married to something. That can kind of put me off a little bit. But in the grand scheme of things, consistency is a relative term that you can use to your advantage. See, being consistent doesn't necessarily mean you have to do big things consistently. It can be little tweaks that you repeat over and over and over that will elevate your photography skills. And not just photography, I mean, you can use this for anything. Let's discuss together how we can create a plan to set you up for success in 2022. Now, the only constant that I will recommend is quality. Now, notice how I said quality, produce quality work. Now, with understanding that quality is the constant, let's talk about things that you can do. Let me give you some examples that you can do for 2022 consistently to develop your skills. One of my favorite things to recommend to people to do consistently is to edit their photos. I'm always surprised how often photographers don't want to edit their photos, and sometimes it can be a moral reason. They don't want to manipulate their photography, which I understand, but the amount of times that photographers say they don't have the time and that they just don't want to is more often the case. Editing your photos doesn't mean you have to spend hours and hours in Photoshop manipulating every last detail. No, I mean, simply, you can use any program. You can use GIMP, you can use Lightroom, you can use your phone, you do whatever you want. But just practice the editing, because it'll help you understand cropping, it'll help you understand how good of a quality your image really is, because when you zoom in on the details, you start to realize, well, maybe I didn't have this in focus like I thought I did. And it helps you hone in on your skills. Furthermore, editing is a whole nother part of the art in photography that I think you have to involve yourself in if you want to really find your style. So editing, that's one little proposition that I'll give to you. Just try to do it consistently. Now let me give you another one. Dedicate a day to going out and doing street photography or portrait photography, landscape. Doesn't matter, but just at least try to dedicate one day, dedicate 1 hour a week. Just try to do it more often and less sporadically. Just like with the editing of the photos, when you start to do this more often on a weekly, daily basis, you start to realize that maybe your skills aren't as good as you think they are. And when you photograph more consistently, you start to come across the same problem over and over. And sooner or later, you're gonna figure that out. You start to have that in your memory bank. So if you ever come across that problem again, it'll be eliminated. So that way, the more consistently you do it, the faster you'll start to learn the whole process. I know one thing that intimidated me when I first started out doing night photography or street photography was having low light. And that forced me to understand how to manipulate the ISO, how to manipulate the aperture. And those are things that, you know, when you don't practice them that often, you're kind of just guessing. And when you actually know, as opposed to guessing, that's when you start to separate yourself from the average photographer. One last thing that I'll propose to you that's kind of fun and that I'm actually currently doing right now is try to post one quality image or content, whatever that is, a day on your social media of choice. It could be TikTok, it could be Instagram, Facebook, whatever it is. But do it once a day. Do this for as long as you can, and you'll start to develop a sense of what kind of photographer you are and what you like and how you like to make people feel. Now, although I am recommending this for 2022, you can get started today. For the last few months, I've been posting at the very minimum one picture every day on my Instagram. I'm not doing this for money. I'm not doing this because I want to be famous. I'm doing this because I want to prove to myself that I can be consistent. I want to prove to myself that I can be disciplined, which is super important to my photography, because I know that if I can do something consistently, I know that I can consistently grow and sharpen my skills and become the best photographer that I can be. Otherwise, I'm selling myself short. And guess what? I've outgrown that. Now that I've got that down pat, I've said, well, what else can I do? And I said, well, I'm gonna do something really out of my comfort zone, and I'm gonna start producing YouTube videos, because that's what social media is designed to do. It's designed to have people give you feedback, and sometimes that's really important, because you might be producing something that you really enjoy, but if somebody else finds joy in it, wouldn't you want to share that? And by doing that, you might join a community of other like-minded people that are just like you. And that will catapult your photography leaps and bounds. And that's something that you can't pay for. And it's something that you created. What I hope that you get out of this is that consistency is key here. Start getting in the mindset of producing once a month, once a week, once a day, but as long as it's not once in a while. I know there's a lot to unpack in this video, but if you feel like anything resonated with you, or if you have any comments or any advice for me, I would love to hear it in the comments. You guys, thank you so much for spending the time with me and just listening to me ramble. And like always, please like, comment, and subscribe. Now get out there and pursue your passion.